Okay. I hope my framing is good. I am Maeve. I'll say that again, facing you, not turning sideways. I'm Maeve. Happy Monday. If you have yoga blocks, have them ready. If you have mini bands, have them ready. Maybe ankle weights, I haven't decided yet. A mini ball. And I have two different dumbbells. Don't have two sets, one of each. That's all I have today. Take a breath up. Get a big extension through your spine. And then bring your hands down to the ground. Walk out to a plank. Little pause here. Consider maybe doing a push-up. You can use your knees. And then walk your hands back to your feet. And then stand it all the way up. And we're going to do that a few times. These are called inchworms. As you do this, start to make the movement a little more connected. Try not to swing your hips side to side. Try not to let the body translate back and forth. And instead, see if you can hold your center as you move forward and back. And again, the push-up is optional. For me, it really kind of lights up my center. And if you're new to me and you're unfamiliar with the way that I approach movement, if something doesn't work for you, please just find a workaround. Find another way to do something if it's not working for you. Good. I'm just going to check you out. I want to see you. I'm not sure it's going to be one of these days. My music stopped. Beautiful. That's perfect, Lisa. Beautiful. Yes. Really nice, Kate. Bravo. Yes. How about two more? When you come up, we're gonna squat, sit back, lift up. We're gonna go elbows to knees if you can, reach up, and you're gonna come up into your toes. Yes. Yes. Four more. Good, heels down. Bring your hands down. Keep your knees bent. Bring the hands forward, hover the knees. Walk back into your squat. Hands come down. Keep the knees bent. Hover the knees off the ground. So sometimes it's called like beast. It's like a floating hands and knees. The hands aren't floating, but the knees are at least. So take them like you want to go to the floor with them, but then stop, just shy. We have two more, please. Come back into that squat. Drive all the way up. Beautiful. One weight, please. Doesn't need to be very heavy. Mine's an 8. It could be anything. It's really about having a driver. You could even just hold a yoga block in your hand. Sometimes just having something in your hand brings awareness to what you're working. You're going to bring that elbow and knee toward each other. We're shortening this side body. Yes, we are. So good. Beautiful. Four more. One more. Hold it up. Switch your hands. Second side. Yes. So I love knowing where you're joining me from. Don't do it now, but at the end, if you feel like it, put it in the chat. Not now. We're in the middle of moving. What made me just think about that is I'm in LA, and LA's pretty, like, pretty ideal weather, right? But it's chilly today. It's chilly. And I know, coming from the East Coast, New England, that we still got it easy. Like, 48 is, like, chilly here. And that's, like, a balmy winter day where I'm from. My whole thought process was, like, okay, I'm getting warm. So if you're somewhere that's cold, we're getting you warm. Hopefully you take this with you through the day. Four more, come on. Honestly, I don't know how I survived the cold. Perfect. Huh, mister? Keep that weight. If you have a mini ball, you're gonna use it now. Even if you have a mini ball, this might not work. I want you to know that. You're gonna put it behind your right heel. You're gonna take your weight in your right hand, and your left leg is gonna come back. Whew. You're gonna kind of find the sweet spots where you feel like you're stable. Really unstable, but stably unstable. Little misters here, Aaron. Roll your chest open. We're gonna take it down. Split stance squat with an elevated front heel. If you wanted to do the same thing for the elevation of the heel, but like this instability or you don't have a ball is too much, you could put your heel on another weight. You could put your heel on a rolled up towel. Four, three, don't go anywhere, stay here. Pulse. Woo. I travel 70 states. Thought moving around make me feel better. Four, three, two, bring it up. Ow. Both sides, I feel that. Okay, second side. Take your time. Use a wall or something to give yourself some stability to do this. And again, if it's not working, it's not working. Don't suffer. Switch hands. Drop down and up. Whew. That's me trying to catch my balance. You're getting both hips here. The more you engage this back hip, this right hip, the more stable you're gonna feel. Two more, come on. Hold it down, we pulse. Bring it up. Oh my goodness. Yoga blocks if you got them. Middle height. Plank. Furniture works as well, like a solid chair. A little more elevated. We're in a plank, breathe. Knee comes in, take it back. We're looking for a crunch here. Crunch, neutralize. Crunch, neutralize. So that means when you crunch, then come back through neutral. Crunch through neutral. Lengthen the spine. the leg that's back is working like crazy. Forward, you got this. Knees down. Stretch it back. Beautiful. Beautiful. Come back up. You're going to cross. Extend the leg. Bend it. Bring it back. Cross. Extend. Bend. Bring it back. And like I said, if that's too much, maybe just the knee cross with a pause and then back to center. Maybe just do one side for two with one knee down and go to the other side. Like 100% make it your own, figure it out. So when I say figure it out, I'm saying that with like so much love and acceptance. I don't want you to like think that I'm like passing the buck to you. I am, because I can't know what you personally need, but you do. So I want you to feel like I'm giving you power of authority there, right? You do what you need to do to make this solid. Still challenged, but really safe. Last one coming up. Beautiful. Walk your feet in. Whoo, enjoy your forward fold. Come back out. You like my smile? Like, that's gonna make it better. Knee comes in, knee drops down, knee lifts up, bring it back. Knee in, knee drop, knee lift, set it back. You're trying your best to bring that knee forward. Last one each side. One more. Beautiful. You need one lighter weight. One lighter weight. Really, really nice work. This could be like real, real light or kind of like medium light. So if you have like one of these bala bangles, this is great. Just enough weight to be aware of your arm and how it moves through space. And if you want a little bit more weight, you're gonna use a little extra weight. If you want a little more elevation, a block under your hand is wonderful. If you need it on the, if you prefer it on the ground, equally good. So you decide, I think I'm gonna use a block. I wasn't planning on it, but I think I'm going to. Your back foot's gonna kick back just a little, I'm sorry, your bottom foot, bottom leg, foot's gonna kick back just a little bit. You're gonna reach down. So I like this elevation because I can let my arm hang and it's not gonna touch the floor. That's kind of why I decided to do it. So right here, do you feel your side a little bit? Good. And then power it up, lift the leg up, bring it down, come back down. Strength up. I shouldn't have said power it up because I don't want you to think that this is like a power move, like if you were doing like a clean or something. It's much more controlled than that. And slow, which does require power. Enjoy this moment right here. It's not just a rest. It's like you've loaded up that side. So good.
It's so written, that's how it goes. No point in resisting the
This is a side plank, y'all, in case you weren't sure. We got a plank party today. All sorts of planking.
And I've been pulled. There is no fooling me no more. No way. I have been
last one right here.
You have no say.
Now hold it. Little lift. No more. That leg is up and down.
I want these lands with open mind and I.
Beautiful. If your knee's the problem, like you've been okay up till now, but you're like, oh, this is a lot on my knee, pat it up. Fold your mat in, grab a towel. Give yourself a break if you need. Keep that leg up high. Try not to let it sink down. Small and high. Yes. Woo. Get longer through the arms, across the chest, longer in your spine. Don't shrink up here. Four, three, two. Beautiful. Set up the second side. So bottom foot kicks a little bit behind. That's going to give you a little more stability so that you don't have to worry so much about your stability. Of course, if you want it to be more challenging, line your foot up to your knee and your hand, and that's going to give you a bigger challenge. Let that arm hang down. Feel that twist. And then take it up. Leg comes up. Place the foot down. Release this back down. Beautiful. I want you feeling that nice twist right here. So I'm using an 8-pound weight. It's very, very doable. I can hold it here with, well, for me, it's very, very doable. I'm kind of giving you the theory behind what weight I'm using. It's not so hard that I'm struggling here. I'm challenged. It's giving me a nice rotation, but I'm not struggling at the top so that I can be there with quality of movement. It's also not so light that I don't even notice it. Like, it's giving me feedback. But my point is, it doesn't have to be super heavy. I think even if I was using one of those little 2-pounders, I'd still feel it. I'd still be aware. So if you feel like you're struggling to hold that top position with integrity, consider lightening your load. I also don't want this to feel easy. Yes. Come on, Elsie. Terry. It's your last one. We're gonna hold it up. If the weight's too much, take it down. We pulse, lift. Be big. Push your hand down, push your knee down. Expand your body. Beautiful. Mm-hmm. Can you make that lifted leg a little longer? Four, three, two. Beautiful. Release all that down. Okay, mini band if you have one. This is going to be hard with a mini band, so I'm going to show you and you'll maybe decide whether or not you want it. And it's totally fine if you don't. I could change my mind too. I'm going to go above my knees because it's going to make it a little easier than if it was at my ankles. You can be in a side plank on your bottom knee or a side plank forearm and bottom foot. It's going to be significantly harder with the bottom foot down. We're here. Lift. Lift. With knee down, it's exactly the same. I didn't actually give you the visual. It's plenty hard like that. Four, three, two, bring it down. Holy smokes. Bend your knees. Stack your hips, whole leg, lift. Keep it up. So I'm gonna keep my top hand on my hip because I sometimes have the tendency to roll back here. Kind of take me out of it. I wanna be here. Push the ground away. Super strong in your side body. This is still a side plank, even though your hip is down. Or side bridge, or whatever you want to call it. Same thing. Good, now bring it up, hold it up. Bring the feet together. Isometric hold, get that knee as high as you can. Still not rolling back toward my butt. Staying forward. Now lift. Lift, tiny, tiny, tiny. So did you see what happened when I started doing that? I kind of collapsed in my shoulder. No. Push the ground away. Yes, yes, yes. Four, three, two, beautiful. Second side. So forearm is down. Knee is down, or foot is down. Let's go. So this requires you to use this bottom hip like crazy. Because you have to stabilize against that lift. Oh my goodness. Three, two, one, bring it down. There's no shame in making it easier. Lift up. You're still in a side plank. Bottom ribs, shoulders super strong here. Try not to roll back. Keep this hip stacked. Come on, little darling. Oh my goodness. Four, three, two. Good, hold it up, bring the feet together, isometric, keep that knee up. Don't roll back, don't roll back. Second side is such a beast, oh my God. Hold it up. Yes, you can, yes, you can. Hold it up, hold it up, hold it up. Now we lift, let's go. Move from your center. Oh my, you're almost done. And beautiful. Mini band comes off. Mini ball again, if you got one. If you don't worry. Don't worry if you don't have one. Let's go like low back. If you don't have one, you can actually be here if you don't have one. Get that nice little C curve. We're gonna have it with or without the ball. So you're drawing back and then lift. Now, we refine this. Your exhale draws back. That's what lifts you up. Don't think about trying to get your shoulders up or your head up. Draw back. As a result, your shoulders come forward. Broaden your collarbones. Next to me. Hold it up. Hold it up.
Pick up one leg, put it down, push down to lift the other leg. So you're pushing down to lift the other leg. Push down, lift from your center. So I like to use my breath here. Exhale to push the foot down, to lift up, and to draw the belly back. The inhale returns me back to my start point. Love this song. Yes, yes. Beautiful. You're gonna take this ball. You're gonna bring it between your inner thighs. The yoga block works, or something else. Forearm plank center. You've got little squeezes. Squeeze, 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 squeeze on that ball, that is, in case that wasn't clear. Squeeze in. If you're using a block, it's the same squeeze. You're just like minimizing it so you don't bruise your inner thighs, yeah? Keep going. Good. Everyone knees down. Keep the squeeze on the ball. Pull your heart forward. Pull your gaze a little forward. Push your right forearm down. Pick up your left arm. Bring it back. So it's like you've got chaturanga, arm in the left arm. Nice and strong. Squeeze on that ball. Left forearm comes back down. Right hand comes back. You've got chaturanga in the right arm. If you're not familiar with chaturanga, it's like a low, narrow push-up. Bring it back, forearm plank. Stay here or, option, lift those knees up. Push into that right forearm. Left hand comes back, hold it, breathe. Bring it home. Push into the left forearm, re-stabilize. Right arm comes back. Bring it back to center, knee taps, knee taps. This is it, this is it. Last 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, knees down. Ball gone, stretch back. Whew. Rise up to your knees. Just take your hands, lace them behind your hips, and open up your chest. Rise up with the arms. Bring your hands down. Tuck your toes. Easy forward fold. Rise up to stand with an inhale. Hands into your heart, exhale. Thank you so much for moving with me today. Bravo. Let me know where you're from.